Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 13 Public Beta 1. This is available to public beta testers now, and came in at 3.37 gigabytes on my iPhone 8. Now, there's a few things you should know that Apple did release public betas for iPadOS as well as tvOS and macOS Catalina, but they did not release watchOS, and that's because watchOS requires you to bring the phone or the watch back if you're having problems with it, and Apple actually has to send it in to revert back to the previous version. So they are supposedly sending some invites to specific people, but I really don't recommend installing watchOS unless you're willing to take that risk as a developer. Now, as far as iOS 13 Public Beta 1, it's absolutely identical to iOS 13 Developer Beta 2. In fact, they have the exact same build number. So let me show you here. I have the Developer Beta 2 on my XS Max here. Now, as you can see, the build number is 17A5508M. It's identical on both the beta and the public beta versions of iOS. And so iOS 13 is identical in every way between the two. In fact, I have a friend that emailed Craig Federighi, the head of engineering or software engineering at Apple, and he confirmed this. And check out the email here on the left. He confirmed that it is identical. So everything you need to know about iOS 13 Beta 2 is in a separate video that I did. There's no differences between the two, but there are a lot of bugs, and this video is more about should you install iOS 13. So I've done videos on iOS 13, 13 Beta 2, and iPadOS as well. So all of those changes are identical, and you can check those out. But I also did follow-up videos on whether or not you should install it because there's so many bugs in it. So iOS 13 Beta 2 has over 100 bugs in it still, and you need to be aware that things will crash. In fact, doing things like voice dictation will crash, and sometimes apps don't launch. Sometimes touch responsiveness doesn't work on iPadOS. There's a lot of bugs all throughout, and that's to be expected with an early beta. But things like dark mode are present all throughout now, so that's a nice little feature under display and brightness. There's new features all throughout the OS, and it's really nice to use. So if you're not afraid of those bugs, definitely install it. But if you're afraid of bugs, check out those different videos I did on follow-ups, because there's over 100 responses of people's experience with iOS 13. And also keep in mind that 3D touch is not the same in this update. In fact, I did a video on why it might not be around anymore. It feels more like haptic touch, but it could be a bug. But so far, it has not been fixed. It basically feels like haptic touch. If you push a little bit harder, it will pop up faster sometimes, but it's basically the same. As far as performance, though, performance is quite good. Battery life is questionable, but that's to be expected with an early beta. So if you're afraid of bad battery life, I definitely don't recommend installing this. And also apps crashing. And if you have things that are critical to what you do, I would never install this if it was up to me. As far as production apps like LumaFusion on the iPad, that doesn't even run properly when you try to export. It often crashes. So if it's critical to production or work, definitely don't install it. But if you have an extra iPhone around, an older one that's supported, go ahead and install it. It's a nice experience. And then you can give some feedback if you're having issues. So you go into the feedback app, select what issue you're having, iPad and iOS, for example. It will pull some logs from your phone, and then you can actually just tell them what's going on and send that off so that Apple can prioritize fixing bugs and make it better for all of us overall. And that's really it for the public beta. Now, when iOS 13 Beta 3 comes out, probably next week, of course, there's going to be more and more bug fixes, and there will be public betas to follow. So we're not sure if it's going to come out July 1st or July 8th. I would guess July 1st, since that's 2 weeks from Beta 2. But it's hard to say at this particular moment. But I really enjoy using iOS 13 despite the bugs. Battery life has not been really that great, and I definitely would say if you're worried about battery life, skip this one for now and try it out a little bit later. And about 5 hours is what I'm getting out of my XS Max. So not great for me. It is great for others. But let me know what you think in the comments below. I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to get these videos as soon as they're released. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.